here's how to absolutely crush a job interview. Man, I wish I had known this stuff when I was younger, going through the interview process. Whew, I certainly flopped on my share of interviews, but have no fear because I'm going to give you some great information. Now, I give a lot of free information, free wisdom across my YouTube channel, but today I'm dropping some gold nuggets in your lap. But just like any of the wisdom that I share, it's only as good as its application. Because if you see a great quote, if you see some wisdom and you read it, and it's words on paper or words on a cool plaque, it doesn't mean a thing until it's applied into your life. So take these 10 tips for how to crush a job interview and apply them into your life. All right, let's get started. Now, before I give you these 10 tips, this is just if you're going to work for somebody else. The real goal is to work for yourself and never, ever have to interview for anybody. But until you get to that point, until you have figured out what your dream is and how to make money at your dream, you will be working for other people. That's just the way it is. So you're working for other people, you need a job interview, get that job interview, start working, get some money coming in, and figure out what your dream is and start working for yourself if you can do that. That being said, let's jump in and start figuring out what these top 10 are. I looked across a lot of leaders, a lot of people out there, a lot of sources to gather all of this information. I've asked friends, I've asked professional executive people that I know in my life. I pulled from some of my own experience, and you are getting the best of the best in this top 10. Now, as I give you these 10 tips, I've got all this information written on my laptop, which is right underneath the camera. So if you see me glance down, I'm looking at that information because there's so much of it. Normally, I'm speaking from my heart, looking right in the camera and just sharing the stuff that's on my heart. But this time is a lot of information, so forgive me if I glance down and look at my notes. Number one tip, you need to do your homework. You need to know about the company, about the person interviewing you, and about the position. Those are the big three things you need to do homework on before you ever step into a job interview. Go to their website, look at the company, figure out how long they've been in business, how many locations they have, what are their core values, who the person is that's interviewing you, what position they have, what title they have, how many employees they have, are they a successful company, figure out who their competitors are. This is information that's going to be really cool in an interview if you know this stuff and it comes up in the conversation. They're going to be highly impressed with that. Now, if you get the person's name who's interviewing you, go on LinkedIn, go on Facebook, figure out who the person is, figure out who their what their likes and dislikes are. Now, don't be weird. Don't be creepy and looking at their Facebook and figure out that they've been married three times. Certainly not something that you want to bring up in a job interview. But you can figure out about the person, how long they've been with that company, that they like golfing or they like tennis or they like swimming. Whatever it is, you can kind of bring that up casually that you like that stuff just to ring a bell with them and you've got that instant bond. So do find out some information about the person who's going to be interviewing you. And certainly you need to know about the position. Most jobs, when they post a position that's going to be worthy of an interview, they tell you the job requirements in there. You need to look at those. You need to learn those. You need to write them down and see where you fit into those requirements and have stories for how you fit into those requirements. So certainly know the position. Number two tip, you need to prepare for your arrival. Now, here's some things to think about. Be dressed appropriately. Now, always go one step above what they ask for. Remember, you're not the only one getting interviewed. There's a lot of people going through this process. Be one step above what they ask for. So if they say, oh, it's casual, go business casual. If they say it's business casual, put a sport coat on. If they say it's something a little bit more than that, always be one step above. Now, don't go to the point where you're wearing a tuxedo in there. There's a limit to it, but always be dressed a little more than what they ask for because it shows respect. You definitely want to have a nice notebook and a nice pen and extra resumes when you go to an interview. That should be in your hands. Now, I don't mean a spiral-bound crap notebook, and I don't mean a little big plastic pen. I mean something nice because that shows that you care about things, that you are a perfectionist, that you love quality, that you're there to impress, and they're going to notice. So get you just a little leather-bound notebook from Office Max or Office Depot or Staples or something like that. Get a nice notebook and a nice little pen. I don't mean a $100 pen. You can get a $5 pen that's really, really nice. Go in there with that and then have extra copies of your resume, because that preparedness going into the interview is going to go a long ways. And this probably goes without saying, but there's a lot of interviews nowadays that are virtual. So make sure you sign in about 5 minutes early, just being ready and being there. Check yourself out. Practice on the side and make sure you've got good lighting. You're not in a basement. Don't do some stupid virtual background. Just have a white wall behind you if you don't have something nice behind you, or a brick wall or a doorway. Something that's nice back behind you. Good lighting. Normally that front right lighting coming in at your face like this is good. You want to have a ring light. If you use a ring light, do not wear glasses. Ring lights and glasses do not go together. If you wear glasses, don't have a ring light. But make sure that your face is lit up nicely. Also, you want to have your camera at eye level. Make sure you're looking straight ahead or a little up at the camera. Don't be looking down at your laptop and have it way low, because it's not a good look. So don't be in your basement. Don't have your hair all messed up and a terrible background. Don't be looking down. All these things you can prepare for in a virtual environment. Make sure you do your homework. Nice lighting, nice microphone, practice with a friend. Make sure it really looks good and you look the part. And some people just wear, they dress up from the, you know, right here at their chest. They just wear a nice shirt or a sport coat. They wear shorts or whatever because it's not even seen. It's not about the fact that your shorts or your tennis shoes or your flip-flops or your Crocs are not going to be seen. It's how you feel. Go ahead and dress the part. Go all out. Nice pants, nice shoes, nice socks, shirt, everything buttoned up. Because if you look good, if you dress good, you feel good. And if you feel good, that's contagious. It spills out and you feel professional, you feel buttoned up, and it's going to come across. If you're sitting there in Crocs and shorts or whatever, or just your underwear, it's going to come across and they're going to read it and you will not get the job. Number three tip, when you arrive, bring your A game. Here's some things to think about when you arrive. Make sure that you are polite to everyone. If you see somebody coming out and you're walking in, speak to them. Hey, how you doing? How's your day going? Come in, hold the door for people. Be super nice to the front desk person. Whoever that is checking you in, ask them how they're doing. It kind of warms you up and gets you loose to start a conversation. Man, it's cold outside. Man, it's hot outside. It was tough finding a parking place. This is an awesome place. I love this building. Whatever it is, start a small conversation with that person, because you don't know, the person at the front desk could be the son or the daughter of the person interviewing you. So if you go in and you're treating them like crap and you're just in your own world and don't say anything, guess who's telling daddy when you leave that you were a butthead when you came in? Don't do that. Be super nice and talkative, not over talkative, just enough. Be respectful of the place, but go in there and be prepared. Sit down, have a little conversation, be nice to everyone, because everyone matters in a job interview. When you come in, make sure you give a solid handshake. Don't be weird. Don't squeeze it. Don't pump it. Don't grip it, you know, like you're trying to see who's the strongest man or strongest woman in the room. Just a nice solid handshake, usually a two pump shake, and you're good. That's a good solid professional handshake, and make sure you're looking them in the eye and that you smile. When you sit down, keep your posture up nice. Sit up straight. Don't lay back. Don't slouch. Don't put your arms crossed on the table. Certainly don't lean back with your arms folded. Don't do that. Be very conscious of how you're sitting. If you cross your legs, it's okay that it's under the table, but don't be weird about it and make it lay you back. Just keep your feet planted on the floor. Keep your hands in your lap or on the table if you're writing something. Make sure that you're aware of your posture. And here for you young people, oh wow, no slang talking. Make sure that you're not talking like you're talking to a friend and you slip up into the slang. Be very professional. Say all of your words. I've got another video about Gen Z and millennials and the way they talk with saying like every other word. Like this is like what I'm going to like do when I'm like here in like this new position. Don't do that. Not a good thing. Don't say to be honest with you or I'm not going to lie. Don't say those things because you're in a job interview. Of course, you're not going to lie. You shouldn't lie. And you shouldn't say that you're going to tell the truth because then everything else you said is assumed that it's a lie. So make sure you're really careful with how you speak and how you speak professionally. And watch the person's body language that you're talking to. Do they look bored? Are they clocked out when you're answering? Are they drifting away? Make sure that you command attention and look them in the eye and ask questions back. Keep them involved, but watch their body language. If you're talking too long, they're going to clock out. Keep your length of your answers in tune with the person listening. Number four, this is a big one. Know your strengths and weaknesses. You will be asked that question. What do you think your core strengths are? What do you think your weaknesses are? Have answers for those. Now, a couple of strengths that I've written down, just as an example, I'll read them to you. Here's a strength that I've got. I try to always do more than I'm asked if the situation allows that. So when I'm given a task, I always try to do a little bit more than that. I think that's a good strength that I have. Number two, I'm very resourceful. If I don't know an answer to something, I'll try to figure it out myself. But if I can't figure it out, I'll go to the right person and get the answer. So I consider myself kind of a resourceful person. That's good. Number three, strength. I don't focus on my mistakes. When I make a mistake, I try to really focus on my solution and how I got around it or how I got over it, how I conquered that mistake. So I don't focus on mistakes, and I think that's a good strength that I've got. A weakness. Here's just a weakness that you can throw out there. You might have your own weaknesses. Just don't get yourself out of the job by listing a weakness. Well, I'm a drug head. Don't do that in the job interview. Here's a weakness. I find it hard to work in a critical or political environment. Normally, people can work anywhere. They're a chameleon. They can blend in anywhere. But, you know, it's tough for me if I'm in a critical environment. That's a weakness, and it's good because you're confessing, you're saying that. That's not going to prevent you from getting the job. It kind of says for them, ooh, do we have a critical environment in there? And it's kind of a self-check, so they're going to be thinking about that if they're a political environment. And when I say political, I don't mean like government and president and who's running for office. I don't mean that kind of politics. I mean office politics. Like the only reason you're going to get that job is because of who you know. The only reason you get these favors or that raise is because of who you know. That's office politics. So you can say that one of your weaknesses is not working well in an office that has office politics. Another weakness that you can throw out there is, well, I'm a perfectionist. And as a perfectionist, it takes me a little longer to do things sometime. And it makes me a little harder to accept criticism because I really want it to be right. So you're kind of given weaknesses that are actually positives, but you're doing it in a way to where you can answer the question. Number five tip for how you can crush your next job interview. Expand on your answers. Try not to ever give a yes or no answer. And they go, blah, 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 blah. Yes. Don't do that. It's boring. That's not what they're looking for. They're not really looking for a yes or a no. They want a no and a why. They want a yes and a why. So whatever their question is, always expand on your answer. And if you could volley it back to them, that's great. So when they ask you a question and you say, yeah, as a matter of fact, at my last job, da la 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 la, have you ever heard of that company? So you're throwing it back to them. That's always engaging anytime you can throw it back. And try to use the interviewer's name. If their name is Sally or Mike or Mr. Johnson or Mrs. Hatfield, whatever it is, try to use their name every now and then. Now, you can overdo this. There's some salespeople that overdo it and it drives you crazy. You don't have to do it with every answer. But every fourth or fifth answer, if you throw in their name, oh, wow, Mike, that's a tough question. See how this? It's just so easy to do that. And it bonds you. It's something that's just magically interactive when you drop their name. But make sure when you answer, you volley it back if you can. Number six tip, and this is a big one. Be ready for behavioral questions. This is the most common thing in that middle tier position that you're going to find. You'll see nowadays people are asking behavioral questions and they're looking for well-thought answers. I've got in the list below, in the description below, I have a ton of behavioral questions that you can prep for. Go through every one of those and have an answer for those. But here's just a couple of them. Hey, can you tell me a time when you had to handle conflict? And then they're silent. So you better be prepared to do that. Whether it's in your family, whether it's in your job, whether it's at school, whatever it is, tell me a time when you had to handle conflict. You give that situation and you give how you resolved it if you can. A second one, name a time that you faced a challenge or a struggle. So, oh man, it was really hard for this, or I really struggled here. Be ready to give an answer for that because they're looking for somebody who's well-versed and can communicate well and has had a life of experiences that they can share. Here's another one. Can you tell me what your greatest accomplishment is so far? So if you won state championship, if you made an A on so-and-so, if you were valedictorian, whatever it is that you are, whatever it is that your greatest accomplishment is, share that. And sometimes it's in sports. Sometimes it's in academics. Sometimes it's in relationships. Be ready with an answer and a story for that type of question. Number seven tip, and this is one you don't hear very often, but it is so important. And it will make you prepared for the unknown. Be familiar with industry terminology. So if you're going in for a marketing job, you need to know all those acronyms, SEO, CRM. You need to know all this stuff. And then the terminology, an email drip, Facebook pixel, whatever it is. So whatever your position is, whatever the industry is, be familiar with the terminology. Because there's nothing worse then if they asked you a question, hey, at your last job, what CRM did you use? That is so embarrassing if you have to say, what's a CRM? You need to know the acronyms for your industry. Be prepared for that and know the terminology because it's key. And if you can even throw it back with your own terminologies that they haven't even mentioned yet, that's very impressive that you can do that and be familiar with the language that they're used to speaking every day. Number eight tip, don't be scared to say no or I don't know. When you're asked a question, don't look like a deer in the headlights trying to lie your way out of it and fake your way through it. Just say, I'm not sure about that. Can you explain that? Or ask, can you ask that question again? Or no, I don't know. Do you have experience in da-da-da? No, I don't. I wish I did. And I worked at another job where it was similar, but no, I don't have experience in that exact thing. So don't be scared to say no or I don't know. You look smarter when you say no or I don't know, rather than faking your way through it, because you're gonna dig a hole and your inner voice is gonna start talking and you're gonna be blabbing and blabbing down a rabbit hole that you can't get out of. So don't be scared to say no or I don't know. Number nine, and we're getting ready to land the plane. Be prepared with great questions. At the end of every interview, no matter what it's for, they always say, do you have any questions? Don't say, nah, I'm good. That's the worst thing you can do. And don't ask dumb questions. So here's a couple of questions that I'm going to read to you that are great for closing an interview. What are you most looking for in the winning candidate for this position? That's great. You need to know that. You're interested. And they might give you an answer that you can go on. So if they go, well, we're really looking for somebody who blah, blah, blah. Oh, I didn't tell you that. That's me. So that's a great question to find out exactly what they're looking for. Here's another one. Can you tell me about the team around this position? That lets them know that you're forward thinking. So, oh, it's in a room, you got 10 people on the team, you're gonna be this person, there's four other people that do the same thing, and then you have a boss, whatever. So ask them about the team that surrounds this position. Ask them about the people in there and what they do, kind of that team, because you're thinking forward and you're letting them visualize you in that position. Great question. Here's another one. How would you describe your company's culture? That's a great question. Companies have culture. They pride themselves with their culture. If they go, oh, I don't know, then maybe you don't want to work there. You need to make them want you as much as you want them, as much as you want to work there. So ask them about their company's culture. How would you describe it? So if they go, oh, it's fun, it's exciting, it's edgy, we're business casual, we're very positive thinking, we're motivated, we're this, we're that. That might be a culture that you're looking for, that edgy, kind of fun, or your personality. See that it's a culture that fits your personality. It might not fit you. If they're like Bozo the Clown walking around, then you might not want to work there. Make sure you ask about the company's culture. Here's another great question. Do you offer promotion pathways for people who go up and beyond what's expected? That's a great question because you don't want to be in a dead-end position. So you're asking, hey, how do people get promoted in your company? And is there a pathway for promotion for people who do a little bit more than what's expected? That's a great question because you're planting the seed that you're going to be that person. You're going to do that. You're going to do a little more than what's expected. Great question. Here's another one. Is there anything I did or said in this interview that might be perceived as a weakness or might keep me from winning this position? Ooh, that's a tricky one. But it's a great question if you could be brave enough to ask it. Is there anything that I did or said in this interview that could be perceived as a weakness and might prevent me from getting this job? They'll tell you right out. Yeah, the second question that I asked you, you bombed it. Oh, I'm so sorry. You know what? In my head, I was talking to myself and I thought that was a stupid answer. Let me give you the answer that it gives you a second chance. It might give you a mulligan. If you're a golfer, you know that term. A mulligan is a do-over. So it might give you a do-over, which is great. And regarding the questions that you're asking, write the answers down. That's why you've got your notebook there. Write the answers down. Be prepared to do that. And it makes you look smart and you've got things to study for your next one. So you've got answers to questions that are going to help you later. And the 10th and final tip, how to crush your next job interview. Have a memorable finish. Make sure after your interview is done that you're sitting there, you're ready to get up, you get up, you handshake, you look them in the eye, you're smiling, thank them for the opportunity. Thank you so much for seeing me today. I really appreciate it. Sounds like you got a great company. I'm super excited about this position and I look forward to hearing from you. That type of thing. Make sure that you're sincere on your exit and you make a mark. Then when you leave, make sure you tell the receptionist, bye, have a great day, it's good to see you. Something like that. Then they're going to remember you as well because they see all the interviewers coming in all day long for several days. Make sure you stand out. Also, you want to send an email to anybody who was in the interview process. So make sure you send them a quick email. Get their business card. You may already have their email. Look on their LinkedIn. Look on their company page. Somehow get their email address, anybody that you came in contact with, and thank them. Thank you so much for seeing me. Really appreciate it. Sounds like your core values in your company are something exciting, and I would love to be a part of it. Something like that. Here's the thing that's going to set you apart. Now, nobody does this, so it's going to set you apart. Hand write and mail a handwritten letter. So get note cards from Office Depot, Office Max, Staples, something like that. Some nice little postcards. Write in there, note cards, not postcards, note cards. Write in there, thank you so much for seeing me. Thanks for the opportunity, blah, blah, blah. Make sure you put that in the mail. 2 or 3 days later, they're going to get it, and you are the one that they're going to remember. So make sure you add that little touch. There you go. Oh, another one. If you're doing it virtually and you're signing off, make sure you're disconnected before you get up and start talking. You don't want to hit end meeting and then go, oh, well, that sucked. You don't want to do that because they probably still see you. Make sure you're completely disconnected before you make any comments or before you get up. There you go. Thanks for being here. Really appreciate it. Make sure you look across my channel at all my other stuff. I just dump wisdom into you guys once a week or once every other week. I really appreciate you being here. Hope you enjoyed this one. It's just information unless you apply it into your life. So apply this stuff. See you guys. See you next time. Thanks for stopping by.